Welcome back to the recap of the lesson Two Deer, written by Count Leo Tolstoy. The story was quite unusual and unexpected. The annual expense of the king increased due to the murderer. Thus, king thought of removing the guard. But it was a surprise for the king that the prisoner never showed a sign to leave the prison. Instead, he went out of the prison and fetched food for himself and locked himself back in the room. The king called him and asked why he did not run away. For that, he blamed the king for spoiling his name and character. Then he pointed out that he would not even get a job, and he blamed the king once again. He would have executed him once he declared the death sentence. Thus, king was forced to pay 600 francs every year. But the prisoner demanded one-third of it in advance. With that money, he purchased land and started market gardening. He made appointment to come regularly to collect his pension. According to the order, it was a good thing that murderer did not commit his crime in a country where they do not grudge expense to cut a man's head off or keep him in prison for life. The title of the story. Let us go in deep regarding the title of the story. The title of the story is quite apt and suggestive. The story is about a king and his kingdom, which find sit. Too dear means too expensive. A murderer committed a crime in the kingdom of Monaco. He was put to trial by the court, but after the discussion, he was sentenced to death. It was declared that he should be executed. Executed means killed. But the kingdom neither had a guillotine nor an executioner. The king was not ready to spend on renting a guillotine nor an executioner from France or Italy. Thus, it was declared that, we can say that king altered the punishment from life sentence to lifelong imprisonment. The title Too Dear means too expensive. Here you can see that king was in a fix to tackle the issue of the murderer or what to do with this criminal. A guard was appointed outside the prison. When he altered the punishment, a guard was appointed to bring food or fetch food for the prisoner. The annual expense of the kingdom increased due to the murderer. Then king slowly removed the guard, and the king was waiting the prisoner to run away, but he never did so. From this we can understand that the prisoner was very shrewd and practical. He told the king that he had nowhere to go, and he blamed the king for spoiling his name and character, and he told that nobody will give a job for him, and he told that he would have. It is his mistake that he never fulfilled his first verdict, and he was forced to pay 600 francs every year. Thus, the title proved to be too dear for the king, means too expensive for the king. Now let us go deep into the four markers. Now you can see that there are two questions here. Why king altered the decision, or why the authorities in Monaco failed to carry the sentence. Now here in this question, I have highlighted and underlined the key points of this answer. For your exam's sake, you may do so if you are quite sure about the points, and if it is a no spelling mistake, you can underline or highlight the answer. Now let us see this answer. The four markers means you have to write for 80 to 100 words. The authorities in Monaco failed to carry death sentence. The first point is what? They were had guillotine nor an executioner, nor they failed to borrow or hire an expert from the neighboring country because it was costing too much. And Italian government quoted 12,000 francs. If he have to raise so much money, the king will be forced to pay or impose 2 francs as a tax from per head. That means from every single citizen. Thus, they changed their sentence. So, next question. Question number 2. Describe Toy Kingdom, or why Monaco is called as Toy Kingdom. Talking about the size, or the location is near the borders of France and Italy, and it have only the inhabitants of 77,000 inhabitants. The narrator calls it a Toy Kingdom because it does not have glory, splendor and strength of large kingdom, but it have to maintain, or it maintained, courtiers, ministers, bishops and general. And the army had only 60 men. There were also taxes in the kingdom. So this is named as a Toy Kingdom. Third question. Describe the different levels of punishment. So for the first king ordered, the verdict is to death sentence, but due to the lack of guillotine and executioner, it is changed to life imprisonment. After 6 months, king noticed an additional expenditure, so he thought of dismissing the guard. Then finally he have to pay 600 francs in order to get rid of the criminal. So we see various times the council and the king change their verdict according to their convenience. Fourth question. Why was the criminal reluctant to go out of the prison, or why he refused, or why did the murderer refuse to go out of the prison, or why he was unwilling to run away? For above all questions, same answer can be written. The reason why he refused to escape is the judgment given by the King of Monaco had ruined his character by calling him as murderer. Next is, people will turn their back and nobody will employ him. And he felt that he was being badly treated, because he initially a guard was appointed, but later on they changed him and he was forced to go and collect the food from the palace kitchen. He said that first they would have declared or executed the death sentence. It did not happen, so he had not complained about that, but they keep on changing. That created a commotion in his life. Then that created a commotion in the life of the prisoner. The judgment was changed and he was sentenced for life, and guard was put to bring him the food, and that was removed. This time he was asked to go away from the prison, which he was not willing, as he found his life secured in the prison. So not last point is very, very important. He felt that his life in the prison is more safe and secure than outside world. So he opted to stay in the prison. Fifth question. The criminal leads a comfortable life after his release. Explain. Or how did the criminal benefit from the pension he was offered? The king of Monaco offered a pension of 600 francs. The criminal agreed to go away, but on one condition: he must receive his 1/3 of his annual income in advance. So he emigrated. He settled down. He bought a small piece of land in neighboring country and started market business. And he will come regularly to Monaco to collect his pension and lead a peaceful and comfortable life. Sixth question. Though gaming is a dirty business, why does the King of Monaco resort to it? King of Monaco imposed or levied taxes like tobacco, wine, spirit, and a part of poll tax. But still, he was unable to maintain or manage his kingdom. So he imposed an additional tax or a special revenue in the form of gaming house. Seventh question. Describe the attempts made by the ministers in solving the problem. Monaco, the king led, though had well-coordinated legal system, but there was no executioner to cut the head. So the king did not have a guillotine nor an executioner. So he tried with the neighboring countries, but both it was expensive. So finally, he told his soldiers to cut the man's head. But the soldier replied that they were not trained to do so. So the king changed his punishment to life sentence to lifelong imprisonment. But after a year, the king met him in a after a year, king met the additional expenses in their annual budget. Then king asked the prisoner to run away, but he refused to do so, and finally king was forced to pay a pension of 600 francs. So, dear girls, so we have discussed 8 questions for 4 markers, and I'll be sending the PDF file of this question answers along with this video. I hope the explanation, the points were clear to you all, and if you have any doubts, I will clear all the doubts in the interactive session. And please do write the assignments. Thank you. Have a nice day.